you know, I was pleased with our guys and the way that that we battled there on the road. You know, we came up a little bit short. You know, against a really good Navy team that did a nice job of executing their game plan, and we had a tough time. You know, containing their offense, they were able to run the ball, you know, pretty well against us, and you know, and they made the plays that were necessary to win the game. You know, our guys thought did a good job of competing for four quarters. You know, we came down to the end. You know, got the last possession, or one of the last possessions, to move to tie it up, but we had a turnover that. You know, that kind of stalled our efforts. But, you know, I'm looking forward to getting back out on the field. We have a great Tulsa team that's coming in, that's playing with a lot of confidence. They're 5-2 overall. I think their two losses are both to top 25 teams. You know, it's an explosive team offensively that scoring a lot of points. And, you know, it's going to be a tremendous challenge for us. But, you know, we're excited to get back home and be able to, you know, play another great opponent.
We'll take questions for Coach Mike Norvell. Please, *1 on your telephone keypad to join the queue. Then the operator will introduce you.
We'll go to Vance Satoro with WakeUpCallDT.com.
Good afternoon, Coach. How are you?
Doing well, myself.
Doing well. Thanks for asking. To speak on, you know, through these seven games, your quarterback, Riley Ferguson, just what he has meant to this team, and obviously his output and kind of on and off the field, maybe some of the things we can't see during a game that you see as a coach as far as his leadership goes.
You know, I think Riley's really growing. You know, he's done a nice job of you know, his preparation, you know, away from the building, his preparation, you know, there, you know, throughout the week, so that he has a great deal of confidence in the schemes, the concepts, you know, his study of the of the different breakdowns that we ask him to look at has been pretty incredible. And you know, our guys know that he's doing his part, and it helps give them a lot of confidence in the guy that's taking the snaps. And you know, I think he's continuing to grow each and every week, you know, with his overall understanding, and you know, he's playing at a high level. I thought he in the Navy game was able to really locate the ball well again. It gives him, you know, another game where he's been able to do that. And, you know, I think that as the season progresses, you know, that confidence is going to continue to grow. And, you know, I see him truly getting better each week.
When you look at your team and kind of where you're at right now in your first season with Memphis, to be 5-2 at this point this season, just what you can say about, and we've discussed it before, implementing a plan and seeing the plan come to fruition, what are you seeing week to week that has really just helped you to step in to this team without having a lot of these guys be recruited by you and have them buy in, have them listen, and obviously have them show on the field that they can put it together and put you in a good position?
You know, I think that you know, their response to when adversity strikes has really been something I've been pleased with. And you know, we talk a lot about the chaos that is there within college football, and that's there within life. And you know, even though we do have the two losses throughout the year, you know, the way that guys have responded, you know, they're after games, you know, the day after, even when we've had some negativity, you know, I think those guys, they understand where we're going, they understand the process, and we didn't make enough plays to win the game, you know, there on Saturday, but you guys have come back and bounce back extremely hungry to get the things corrected that we need to correct. And you know, I think there's a trust that is continuing to build. You know, we've been in games where we've been down 14, 17 points, and be able to come back and win those games. You know, we've had games where we've had big leads, and have had to sustain that. So just with all those experiences, you know, guys trusting their training, trusting the coaching staff, and trusting their teammates, you really have seen a lot of growth in those areas, and I think that's helped get us to the point where we're at. And you know, coming off of a loss, you know, we need a great response again this week. And you know, when you're in conference play, I think you look across American Conference. I mean, it's unbelievable, just the number of good football teams that we have, and week in, week out, you know, truly anybody can win. So we know we've got to bounce back. We've got to put a great week of preparation there. there in order to put ourselves in a chance to be successful for Saturday.
Thanks, Coach. I appreciate it.
Thanks, sir.
We'll now go to Brian Moss with TigerSportsReport.com.
Hey, Coach, your defense has been pretty solid all year, but one area that the production hasn't been like in years past has been, to get sacks. What have you done to try to get more production as far as getting sacks? Because I think you're averaging about one per game so far this year.
Yeah, you know, continue to work on our different different personnel packages and packages to attack the quarterback. You know, I think we've gotten good pressure on the quarterback and maybe not always ended up with a sack for the season, but a lot of the interceptions that we've had have been because of pressure on the quarterback or quarterback hits. And so there's going to be a balance of that. You know, we've played the last two games have been predominantly running offenses with Tulane and Navy in their attack, but even up to that point, I feel like we've gotten good pressure, just not always got home on the sack to the quarterback, and so we're looking a lot of our different personnel packages and the different ways we can attack, and I like the way our guys have continued to improve fundamentally in those things, but for us it's just about each week we're going to have a specific plan to try to get home to the quarterback, and even if we're not getting the sack, just to make sure that he feels the pressure and the way that we're attacking.
Is the fact that Latarius Brady, when he came back from injury, in your opinion, how has he improved the defensive line?
You know, Latarius is he's a great leader. He's a guy that's played a lot of football here at Memphis, and as he's getting him back on the field, he went about five and a half, 6 months without playing any football. And so, there's still some things that he's got to continue to work on and kind of getting the rust off. But I tell you, just, his leadership, and he's got, great mobility, being able to get off of the ball. He's a guy that I think is going to help, with the depth and be able to keep fresh guys out there, on the field and bringing in a guy that can definitely make plays, in the run game and also getting there to the quarterback.
I appreciate it.